9:39. You are watching News Channel 3 Live at 9, and we appreciate you doing so. Now, for mystery writers, there's the Edgar Award. For journalists, there's the Pulitzer Prize. And for authors of children's fiction, there's the Newberry Award.
Memphis native Vince Vawter won it for his best-selling book, The Paperboy. And he's ready to introduce you to the newest chapter in the Paperboy's life with his new novel, Copyboy. Vince,
good
welcome back to Live 9. Glad to have you here.
Thank you very much. It's good to
you
be here.
You are really staying busy these days.
Yeah. Welcome back
glad
home.
To have you back home. Right. You've been staying pretty busy these days, haven't you?
Yes, I have. I thought I retired about 12 years ago, and that doesn't seem to be the case.
It didn't work out too well, did
no,
it not?
So Paperboy was sort of autobiographical, kind of.
Mostly, I would say.
Mostly,
yeah. Right,
okay.
Yeah.
And this one, the central character becomes a copy boy. So since you spent, 40 years in the newspaper business,
right,
does
yeah.
this continue the autobiographical theme?
It does continue it. It's got a little more fiction in it, though, I would say.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So tell us about how this book came about, because this wasn't planned, right?
Well, it really wasn't. I told my editor, I told my publisher, I told my agent I wasn't going to write a sequel to Paperboy. And then I was at a school in Florida, mm-hmm. and I had this young lady come up to me, and she said, I want to know what happened to Mr. Spiro, who's a character in the mm-hmm. book.
Right, kind of the mentor.
And I said, well, I can tell you what happened to all the other characters because they were part of my life. Mm-hmm. They were real people.
Gotcha.
And she said, I know that, Mr. Vawter. You made him up once, and you can make him up again.
Wow.
Ooh.
And so that kind of got me.
Mm-hmm.
And so I went home, and I started looking at all my emails. I'd gotten 300 or 400 emails, and I found the readers had a lot of questions about things, and I said, okay, mm-hmm. I'm going to give this a shot. And so that's how we get the copy.
Did you feel, though, Vince, there was enough out there that had not been explored yet to still make it entertaining and interesting, or what?
Yeah, I found there was not more. I had to really look at it.
Really?
And the story, it kind of had to grab me.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't grab it. It kind of grabbed me at some point.
Well, and because you... Let's face it, you're a newspaperman, and newspapermen work in facts. So since this is much more fiction, that must have been harder.
You're exactly right. It's a 180-degree turnaround.
Yeah.
And I had to learn new skills. I really did.
Yeah.
Tease us, though, just a little bit, though, Vince. What do you hope will really grab the reader this time around?
Well... what I wanted to do was to show how the paperboy grew into his 17-year-old self.
Yeah.
With his stutter, he still stutters.
Right.
And so I just wanted to show growth there, and I think I did that.
So it also introduces a strong female protagonist. So do you expect at your next school outing some young woman is going to say, okay, so what happens to...
Well, I tell you what, I was extremely nervous about writing her because...
You're a guy.
Yeah, I'm a guy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But the more I worked with her, the more I kind of fell in love with her.
Awesome.
And so I don't know if we'll see her again or not. I kind of miss her, though.
I predict we will.
There could be a lot of pressure.
Right.
I mean, you've got a chair right here.
That's
you
it.
Might as well
we
make
are ready
some
to have you back.
It.
Right.
Vince
it's good to
Vawter.
See you. Glad to have you back in the Mid-South.
And you can meet him at Novel Bookstore tonight at 6 p.m. We just put that on the screen, so head on out. Thank
good.
You so much.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank
it's
you.
Been nice.